Creating a desirable place to live, work, and play is every community's dream. The Capital Region Council of Governments is spearheading an innovative project that will equip towns with the tools to create vibrant, sustainable communities.
Well, this is a really exciting project because CROG developed a few years ago a set of guidelines for sustainable development, and now we have the opportunity to help communities actually make those visions a reality. In order to create more sustainable communities, you have to have the correct zoning regulations in place. The model regulations created by this project will address four different topic areas: housing diversity and affordability, energy efficiency and alternative energy, food security and local food systems, and compact and mixed-use development, which can also support transit-oriented development.
Some towns have led the way by independently using sustainable land use regulations and policies, particularly those addressing compact mixed-use development. Avon is in the planning stage of this type of project in the historic and geographic center of their town.
In order to try and recreate a sort of classic traditional New England center, you really do need a different kind of zoning tool, a different type of zoning code in order for that to occur. Unlike conventional zoning, which segregates uses by zone, this zone actually specifically encourages a mix of uses, including retail, office, and residential uses. I think that the model codes that CROG is working on can prove to be very helpful to a community that may be interested in doing something similar.
Mansfield for years had the idea of creating a downtown center within the stores section while preserving the rural character of the overall town.
You know, we're, I think, a great community to live in, to raise a family, with the advantages of having a university located right in our center here. But for whatever reason, you know, no downtown ever emerged in Mansfield. I really think that is essentially what we're trying to create here. Is that civic center with a lot of life and vibrancy.
If you went by the zoning that we have today, we couldn't have any of these wonderful, wonderful main streets that are quite dense and intense and that are great places for people to gather. Trying to recreate the zoning that allows for that is such a huge task.
When you're building something that's mixed use around principles of intelligent land use, sustainability, it takes more time to do it right.
Rather than having little strip malls show up here and there all through the town, we now have a town center by concentrating growth upwards rather than outward.
It's about being friendly to people who walk and ride and drive cars together. All those things happening in the same place.
So when you design places in such a way that biking and walking are really viable alternatives, you don't necessarily have as much need to accommodate as much traffic, and you don't need as much parking. I think a lot of young people are looking for places that are more walkable and bikeable and have activity mixed into where they live. And in a lot of Connecticut towns, that style of development is still prohibited by zoning codes.
You could achieve the same thing by implementing a smart code approach or some other model codes, model form-based codes. That could be very helpful.
The Sustainable Regulations Project will help communities with its model regulatory language. This will not only bring more mixed-use developments to life, but will also encourage diverse, affordable housing, greater food security, and energy-efficient development.
What makes these kind of things useful is we're giving people a template of these kind of regulations that they can use in their communities, and that makes it a lot easier. And then you can incorporate and adapt it to your local community circumstances. We want to get out there and help communities to engage and implement this over time.